interview with Dr. Arye Carmon on IDI's Forum for Political Reform in Israel. What is the Forum for Political Reform in Israel?
In October 2009, IDI initiated the founding of a very unique and special forum, the goal of which is to very seriously pursue concrete proposals for reforming and strengthening parliamentarian democracy in the state of Israel. For that end, IDI established the forum comprised of very, very top, unique individuals, some retired Supreme Court judges, a good number of retired members of the Knesset of the first quality. I think the forum includes experts from many universities in comparative politics and electoral systems, and many public figures. Some of us label the forum the Sanhedrin. In other words, Israel, unfortunately, has too many investigation committees. This is the best, the largest, the most thorough investigation committee. IDI asked former Supreme Court Judge Meir Shamgar to chair, and he agreed, and he is the chairman. And IDI provided the forum with a group of nine first-class young researchers headed by Professor Gidi Rahat. The goal of this group has been to provide the forum with proposals in different areas, and this is what the forum has been doing. I think that along six meetings since October 2009, the forum deliberated over a number of ideas and concluded, and the conclusions were now handed to an operational arm established by IDI, what Americans call PAC, Political Action Committee. They have the task of implementing, of getting it to the arena where the action takes place, meaning both in the Knesset and to recruit the public to provide tailwind to this effort.
Please expand upon a few key recommendations of the forum.
Reforms are not an end. Reforms are means to an end. What is really the goal? Since 1996, when Israel unfortunately started the disastrous move of a direct election of the prime minister, we lost what we used to have until 96, namely two solid, large parties that provided to whoever won the election very solid foundation to both plan policies but implement policies. Just to give one number, between 1949, after the first election in Israel, and 1996, in all governments, in each and every government, the ruling party had majority of the ministers, just a number. So the goal is really, we asked ourselves, how can we revitalize, how can we channel institutionally the river called Israeli politics in a direction so that two blocks will emerge down the line, will become two parties. And one of the ideas is this. We say that the prime minister will be announced as prime minister on the night of election day. And he or she are going to be that person who obtained more votes than any other party. Now, we assume and we're pretty convinced that this will lead to coalition-making processes before the election. There will be amalgamations of blocks. At the beginning, there will be, you know, it might be a little loose, but it doesn't matter. This will provide a pattern. And down the line, we believe that we will have solidly two blocks. So that's one example. Another thing that I want to underscore, we have to strengthen political parties in Israel. for much more than one reason. And one of the means that we are now considering, we're pursuing, we have not concluded it yet, is to introduce constituencies into our electoral system, meaning that some, say half of the members of our House of Representatives will be elected in constituencies. We do not talk about single member constituencies such as in the United States. We are looking at some European models of multi-member constituencies, meaning there will be constituencies, districts, that will send, based on the number of eligible voters, between 5 and 7 and 9. This is yet to be discussed, members of the Knesset.
What are the primary obstacles to political reform in Israel?
Any reform has enemies. Someone has to pay the price. And as things are now, in the coalition does not have a majority, because even though we know that some parties, the Likud, for instance, would be interested in such reforms, the Likud is tied up with parties that may suffer from it. And in the coalition agreement, there is a clause that states that any changes in the current electoral system and or constitutional foundation of the State of Israel, any change must receive consensus from wall to wall, and this is hard to achieve. What are we trying to do? We have been starting already, to create lobbies within the Knesset and coalitions within the Knesset among single members of from the coalition and from the opposition, and we are going to invest in creating a big wave, growing wave of public support, so that when the moment comes, we'll be able to move forward. And I can give you two examples. Number one, if there is a coalition crisis, and imagine that the new coalition is in the offing, this will be a great opportunity. Another one, which to me is more realistic, when we know when the date of the next election is, and in a parliamentary reform, you know what is the latest day, but there could be days before it, this will be another opportunity. Because at that time, coalition agreements, we know it from experience, become more loose. So there you are.